Good to be back in God's house.
Yes.
Beautiful morning out there. Isn't God good?
Amen.
Amen. All the time. Let's start with a word of prayer this morning. Father in heaven, we thank you again for this privilege of being in your house. Lord, I thank you, Lord, for each and every one that's here today, Father. Lord, I thank you, Lord, for the miracles that you have performed this week. Lord, for Brother Tom being back home. I ask you, Lord, to continue to be with him and Chris. Lift them up, Father. God, we know that you have all the answers, and we just got to wait on you. And Father, I ask you, Lord, be at this service. Give each song and each testimony, Father. And Lord, bring the message only that you may bring. Someone here might be touched. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Amen.
Yes.
572, Blessed Assurance. While you're turning your pages there, kind of going back to that last one, nothing but the blood. I really like that third verse. Not of good that I have done. There's nothing good that I can do. Nothing but the blood of my Jesus.
That's the God I serve. That's the one that I'm praising about every day.
Yeah.
just to see that work there and talk with Sister Chris and over and over and over so many times, she said, you know, I've just seen so many miracles this week. See so many. That's a God. That's our God we serve. Any others this morning? Yes, brother.
Just if you would, please keep my mom and my mother and all and all the unsaved in my family.
Yes.
Please pray for my daughter-in-law. She's not safe. And pray for my friend Peg from Cincinnati. Her husband from Cincinnati. So those two are. And also, Jeffy's kids, Jeff Mitchell's kids, Sherry's gone. And I think the kids are trying to carry on, but we're kind of worried about Jeff. But Sherry was the mover and shaker of the family, you know. And so we're kind of concerned about Jeff. So please pray for Jeff Mitchell and the other Mitchell kids.
My young musician friend, Justin Chambers, I can see changes in him. His girlfriend was raised in a coal mining community down in eastern Kentucky and was a person of very strong faith, although she sings secular country music and so forth and so on. But it's had an influence on his life. And just pray that he, you know, that God reveals to him what his life can be and that he follows through with that. And we just pray for his salvation.
Yes.
My friend Karen seems to be in critical condition in the hospital this morning. Pray for her.
Who is?
Karen Samshaw.
And yours.
Yes. I just wanted to tell the congregation I appreciate their support the other day. That I'm a miracle sober now for 30 days.
Amen. Thank you.
First time in 6 years.
God bless you.
Amen.
Poor California, though, they got laid off a bunch of great peppers.
Timothy's sick this morning. Pray for him. And the job we were praying about for Jack, he didn't get that, but that just means the Lord got something else in mind. So yeah. Just pray that some kind of position will open up where he doesn't have to work every other Sunday.
Yes.
I'd like for the church to remember Kayla, please, and just remember my family for some sake.
Yes.
I would like the church to pray for me while I sing this song. It's a heart song. Pray for you before and during, which we say.
Anyone else? Yes, sir.
My brother has had a liver ultrasound in the next 2 weeks. He's pretty concerned about it. My family has a history of liver disease.
As church, remember mom, and I bring her all the water to stuff. Remember her. She's going to try and meet for her. She's just going to do some issues with them all day. Any unspoken thoughts with the hands? Let's all stand for prayer. For the bill.
God, we thank you, Lord, for the opportunity again to come to your house. Thank you for these songs that's been sung in your presence. Most of all, we feel God. Lord, now we come to you in prayer. Lord, you know, I can't begin to remember all these, the tests that's been around, Lord, that's coming up. All the ones that just need you to move in their lives and to strengthen them, lift them up, to heal them, God, and to help, Lord, strengthen them spiritually to get through these trials that you're going through. Lord, there's so many that needs a physical touch from you, and we just pray that you just continue to move like we know you're more than able to. In a great position. Lord, just be with this service, each and every song, God. Be with the message that's great this morning. Just anoint it, God. Anoint every aspect, every testimony. Let your Holy Spirit flow through this crowd, God. And Lord, once again, all the requests, just pray in a mighty, personal way, God, that you just move. God will not forget to give you the praise and the glory. And we thank you for the praise reports that you've given this morning, Lord. We want that you have moved on, and the ones you're going to move on. We thank you also for the precious time. Amen.
Amen.
Seven, the old rugged cross.
On a little farther away.
Yes, Judge Jacobus.
Oh, dear Lord, we stand before you this morning. We face you with all of our sins. We also ask for all of your help and guidance in our lives. And this morning, we are blessed with the privilege of putting together a gift. A financial gift it is, but a financial gift that helps the growth of your church here on earth. In all these things, we pray. Amen.
Amen. After the same manner, he took the cup, and when he had supped, saying, "This cup is the New Testament of my blood. This do ye as oft as ye drink in remembrance of me."
For as often as you eat and drink this bread, and drink this cup, ye do show the Lord's death till he come. Wherefore, whosoever shall eat of this bread and drink this cup, the Lord, unworthy, shall be guilty of the body and the blood of the Lord. But let every man examine himself, and so let him eat that bread and drink of that cup. Father in heaven, I thank you again for this privilege. And I thank you, Lord, today, Father, for the beautiful music, Father, that Sherry put forth. I ask you, Lord, to be with the songs that we're going to sing. Lord, I ask you, Lord, to bring the message that he may bring. And Lord, if there's anyone here this morning that has no use for personal safety, Lord, if there's any here that has a need, Lord, I ask you, Lord, to lift each one up. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Tripping all over myself this morning.
This is a real hard song to sing, so be praying.
Thank you.
it's the same as this morning. I don't think there's much of a tour song out there. You don't have to serve the Lord very long and just realize how faithful He is.
Thank you.
my job was terminated. But you know what? Today, John, God worked it all out through all this. Jim and I got victory over all this because, John, the way they worked it out with me and the way they did it all fell right in place. That's the God I served this morning. Through all the hard times, through all the bad times, John, God still comes out victorious. He is faithful, Brother Graham. He's good this morning, church. Yes, I get happy. Yes, I get excited. I got a God that loves me. I got a God that says, you know what? I gave my son and you all can have life. And you can have it more abundantly. John, we all want to be happy. We all want to get excited. He's faithful.
Yes,
we can look at the negative side. It's easy to do. That's the human part of us, to look at the negativity of it. But I look at those little babies that walked in the door this morning. I watched the little one run through the door this morning. And Brother Bill Carter, as she was coming through, I went to grab her. She ran right past me. So I knew I wasn't going to get a chance. But you know what, church? We have a lot of babies that come in this church. This young man come this morning. And I'm going to tell you, I'm praying for him. He just got his braces. Pain. But you know what? He came. God's going to take care of that. God's going to take that pain away. And you need to say, well, Greg, God works that way. That's the God I serve. This morning, church, I tell you, God is faithful. Yeah, I got scriptures I can read, but I'm not going that direction this morning. And yes, they say sometimes, well, you know, we all need to hear scripture. Well, you know what? Open your Bible. Read them. They're there. They're there. I'm here to tell you this morning, children, there's a God that loves you. There's a God I serve this morning to do the impossible. I served this morning, I served God this morning, went down to Christ Hospital. He went in there and he touched a man that they had crushed, that they had brought down because he had to have 3 bypasses. His ribs was busted. Sister Chris called and said, Greg, I need you to pray. We lifted it up to the church. The church began to pray. That's the God I serve. He's alive this morning. Jordan, you know what? If you think your God's not alive this morning, I don't know who you pray to. When you go through troubles and when you go through trials, who do you pray to? If you don't serve the same God I serve, what God do you serve? And what, who are you praying to this morning? My God answers prayer. What's yours, God does? My God stands above the throne and he says, you know what? This morning I'm going to bless like I'm going to open community chapel. And this morning I'm going to go down there and I'm going to be part of them. And we're going to have a wonderful service. That's what God does. Or you could come in the door and say, well, you know what? I made it. I'm in the doors. I'm sitting here. Yeah, it's a wonderful service. Oh, that preacher ain't talking to me. He's talking to some sinner sitting back here. Church, I'm going to tell you something. When Greg speaks, he's speaking to Greg. No one else. When God gives me a message, it's for Greg. I just get to share it with you all. Well, this morning, my message is to you all. It's by God's faith. My God's in the saving business. My God's in the healing business. My God is a God can do anything when everybody else feels like they failed. This morning, back in Psalms 37 chapter, and I told these people Thursday night, so all you all was here Thursday night, forgive me. On my way home from work, I was crushed. be the first to tell you, not expecting it. But on my way from home from work, and when Jill got home, I read this scripture to her. 37th chapter of Psalms, it says, a good man's steps are ordered by the Lord. God knew exactly what he needed for Greg. Greg didn't understand, but my steps are ordered by the Lord. He's going to put Greg exactly where he needs Greg. He's going to use Greg exactly where he needs to use him. And this morning, church, God's using me right here. So I'm telling you this morning, if you don't know the same personal Savior that I am talking about, you can. He loves you. And he stands up here with open arms saying, you know what? You have never been so bad that I can't choose you. Your world will tell you that. So when you go, I remember when you used to do this. I remember when you used to do that. You know what? I remember when I used to do stuff too. But God took all that away. Made a new creature out this morning. I've shared this story many times, but I remember Brother Ray Campbell, an old-time preacher. He got up and he testified that him and his best friend, they used to close the bars every week. They'd be there to the last one. And they'd drink their life away and just party and have a wonderful time. Well, they separated. And God came into Brother Ray Campbell. At his weakest moment, at his vulnerable moment, God came into his life and saved him. He called this old wicked man to preach. And he was preaching this message. He says, you know, and I pray to the Lord, if I can only see some of the guys that I used to go to the bars with and witness to them and tell them about a God that loves them, and to tell them about a God that can save them, tell them about a God that cares about them. See, church, there's a lot of people that don't care about you. God does. Through everything else, God cares about you. Said he happened to be going to a restaurant one night, and across the parking lot, he seen this speller that he used to break down the bars with. He told Ben, he said, I'll be back. I've got to go share the gospel. I've got to go let him know what God done for me. Said he went running across the parking lot and he met this man. He hugged him. He said, you know, I want to tell you something. He goes, well, I want to tell you something too. He goes, well, I want to tell you, you know what? God saved me. I'm preaching this gospel. He goes, well, I want to tell you God saved me too. And he goes, and I'm in church also. Now tell me, Joy, God don't work. Don't let him fool you. Don't let the devil fool you and tell you he can't use you. Some of the most strongest Christians I know were one of the most wicked sinners that walked the earth. See, when God saved them, made a new creature, they was just as bold for God as what they used to be for the devil. Church, my God is faithful. My God's in the healing business. He's in the saving business. And this morning, Jordan, if you don't know him as your personal Savior, there's not a better time. The Bible says today is the day of salvation. If you don't know him, the altars are open. We love to pray with you. If you've got a need, this ain't just for sinners. I've preached on it many times, church. Those altars right there that we put down there are not just for sinners. They're for you to come and talk to God. Say, God, you know what? I got a need. He says, cast your cares upon him. When's the last time, church, that you took the time to ask God to help you through something that you're going through? He's able. He's faithful. And he loves you. As they sing another verse, yes, it's a peculiar service. Yeah, you know, one more time, Greg just passed everything else. Church, I'm like God. I don't go by a book. I don't go by a script. That's why I told Sister Michelle a long time ago, don't worry about writing down. Doesn't wait. If you see that part of what the preacher's going to do, you'll see it blank. Because I don't know what God's going to do. So how can I tell her what Greg's going to do? Because I don't know what God's going to do next. stands up here and he says, "George, if you don't know me, you can." And he loves you. And he's faithful. As we all stand and they sing a verse of song. Sometimes he gets emotional and sometimes he cries. And I laughed at him going to the hospital. I said, "That's great, Tom." I said, "I'm glad you did." I said, "But you know, them were tears that God understands. That's a language that God understands." All hearts clear. Thank you, Lord, for each and every one that's here today. As we bow our heads to be dismissed, Brother Roger, did you dismiss?
Heavenly Father, your Son Jesus is the world's greatest gift. A gift is free. A gift is with no strings attached. And Jesus, the gift of salvation, is exactly that. So many times in our life, there are so many things for us to stumble over that we cannot see. But God knows it all. And the promise is, if we accept God as our Savior, it's always going to be all right. And so as we leave today and go to our homes, let us just remember to take Jesus, God, with us. And whenever we do stumble or we make a mistake, Lord, just lift it up to them. And when bad things happen, just lift it up to Jesus and the Heavenly Father. And they will, as they promise, take care of it. And we just praise you and thank you for that. In Jesus' name, amen.